today's tutorial, we will present 3D Vista's advanced analytics, which is one of the features of 3D Vista hosting. It allows you to monitor and track the traffic inside your virtual tours and is accessed through your personal 3D Vista cloud control panel. Don't be confused by the name cloud. You will continue to create your tours locally and offline in your desktop program VT Pro. Cloud is just an optional online control panel where you can find information about your products, expiry dates of your upgrade plan or hosting if you have them. And if you use the optional 3D Vista hosting, you can also access your tools from here and analyze the traffic it gets with 3D Vista Advanced Analytics, which is what we want to present here today. So, first things first, you can access your 3D Vista cloud simply by typing in cloud.3dvista.com, so you can access and share your tools from anywhere you are, or you can access it from within 3D Vista VT Pro. If you go to the My Tours tab and click on the cloud icon, it'll take you there as well. Log in with your 3D Vista credentials. And there you are. This is your personal 3D Vista cloud control panel with our different sections and information. And we will focus on this one right here, analytics. This would take us to the general analytics panel for all of our virtual tours. But you can also click on My Tours and directly dive into the detailed analytics of a certain tour by clicking on this icon here on the respective thumbnail. So this is like a direct access to the analytics of a certain tour. But let's have a look first at the general analytics panel. Right. So we have two big sections here. The first one is our global analytics, which shows us the total amount of information or data collected across all of our virtual tours. So across all of these tours, which are all listed individually here as well. So we have the total number of visits that were recorded by all the tours together, the total number of users, again, across all of our tours, the average time that they stayed, a list with the countries where those users came from with their absolute numbers and percentages. And we can also click on here to display the whole list. And finally, a graphic where we can see the evolution of the visits. And if you roll over the individual bars, it'll give you detailed information on it as well. Now we can see all of these analytics for different time frames, of course. So all time, throughout the last year, in the last month, last week, or also a custom time frame, say November 29th to 30th. Now the data updates and shows me exactly what happened in those 2 days. So whichever time frame you select up here, all the data here updates accordingly to show you what happened globally and per tour in that time period. Before we dive into the details, the tours uploaded onto your 3D Vista hosting account by default do not appear here in the analytics panel. And that is due to the strict data privacy regulations, because if those tours appeared here, they'd be collecting data from your visitors, and that's a sensitive topic. So by default, your uploaded tours do not collect data, and you have to manually set them to do so. So in order for a certain tour to appear here with the analytics, etc., you need to make sure that you select that option for that particular tour in VT Pro. So in this tour, for instance, I click publish. I select to publish it onto 3D Vista Hosting or cloud. And down here, select the option Enable 3D Vista Cloud Analytics. Then click Publish, and that's all. So very, very easy, and nothing to do with trying to implement Google Analytics where you have to place some code, register on the Google Analytics platform, etc. Here, it's just tick that option and you're good to go. Right, back in our analytics panel, like I said, in the second module, we have a list of all of our uploaded tours, the ones where we did tick the cloud analytics option at least. And for each one, we can see the percentage of views it received compared to the rest of the tours, the total number of visits it received in the selected time frame, the number of visitors, the average time people stayed in and explored the tour, the percentage of visits from the country where most people accessed the tour from, and finally the evolution of the visits throughout the selected time period. And again, all these data are shown based on the time frame we selected up here. So if we change that, you can see that all the data changes as well. You can collapse this section here to better see the individual tour analytics, and maybe you've already seen this tiny little arrow here, which shows that the tours are currently listed from biggest percentage views to smallest. If we click here, it'll turn that order around and list the tours from least visited to most visited. So just the other way around, starting with the least visited tours, these tours right here, which have simply never been visited. And we can sort the list by the total number of visits, the users, etc. So you can immediately see which are the most popular tours in terms of different indicators. And that's your overview analytics for the individual tours with their main indicators. Now we can also dive into more detail for one particular tour simply by clicking on the thumbnail of that tour, and it'll take us to that tour's detail analytics page where we can see lots and lots of data for the tour. Up here, as usual, we can determine the time frame which we want to see statistics for. Here's a button to go back to the list of all of our available tours, or if we want to move to the subsequent tour without going back, we can do so as well with these arrows here, which allow us to move through the different virtual tours to see their details. Up here we have the same indicators that we also had in the list before. And below that, we have the detailed list of countries for this tour, which we can click on to display the entire list as well. Next to it, we have a ranking of the media inside our tour, so which media have been visited the most, whether it's panoramas or photo albums or 360-degree videos, with their percentage, their absolute views, and also their average time visited. And next to that, we have the same ranking for one level deeper even, for the individual hotspots in your tour. So which hotspots have been the most clicked ones? So overall, we have a number of very interesting data to let us know what people tend to visit most, what's most interesting to them, etc. So let's hide this and move on to the next section. Now this module is going down one more level, even more into detail and tracking behavior within specific media of this virtual tour. In this case, we are seeing the data for our entrance panorama, which is the tour's first panorama. And in this list, we can change to visualize a different media, or directly here in the thumbnail list, we can also switch to a different one as well. So what do we have here for this particular panorama? Being the tour's first panorama, it logically has the most views out of all of the media. So we see our percentage views and that this panorama got 13.5% of all views within this tour. In absolute terms, this means it registered 502 views, 1 minute and 46 seconds average staying time, that it contains 15 hotspots, which got clicked 499 times in total. And then we have a list of all the hotspots within this panorama and again their respective clicks and popularity to see which hotspots have been the most clicked ones by your visitors within this panorama. And finally, here we have probably one of the most fun and interesting sections, which is the heat map for this panorama. This shows us in a very visual way the behavior of our tour's visitors and how they move about this scene. Let's make this bigger so you can see for all the different panoramas in our tour where people looked at most and longest. So we can jump from panorama to panorama and see where the hot areas are for each one. Let's take this one for instance. The red part here indicates that the user spent a lot of time looking at this exact spot. So the camera or view is directed at this angle for the most time. This obviously gives us valuable insight on what people consider interesting or focus on most in this panorama or scene. In this case, it's the view into the kitchen here, but also right after that, this artwork here or the staircase area that seemed to call attention as well and where people therefore look at a lot. And then there's a little bit of blue as well here in the doorways or the stairs, which makes sense if you think that people will have to hold on for a second to click on the hotspots to move outside or downstairs, etc. So this is obviously a very powerful and insightful tool that tells you what's most interesting to your audience or which sections are largely overlooked. So in terms of marketing and product placement, this is worth gold. And the more visits you get overall, well, the more valuable information you can get out of this. And you can also base decisions on this. For instance, if you're mounting a virtual store and you want to place a certain product on a shelf that tends to receive lots of attention. And if you're mounting a virtual tour for somebody else, it's also a great reporting tool and very valuable information that you can give them this kind of feedback and details as to where people look. And you can also change the transparency of these heat maps to have them entirely clean or with different intensities of those indicators, depending on what you prefer or what you want to use these maps for. With these arrows, you can move through the different media, but remember that this heat map feature is only available for 360-degree photos, so panoramas, and 360-degree videos inside your tours. So not for normal photos in your photo albums, for instance, or for normal videos that are non-360. Let's close the full screen. And as you can see, for the non-360 media, which we have selected, we do also have the statistics here. If you select a video, what you will see here is just the very first frame of that video. In many cases, especially if your video starts with a fade, the first frame is completely black or completely white. In that case, you would see a black or white screen here as well, just so you know that that's not an error, it's just what your video's first frame looks like. And finally, for the photo albums, you will only see the first photo up here rather than all of them. So this is just for you to recognize which photo album this is, and that's why we're showing the first photo that it contains. And that is it for the 3DVista Advanced Analytics. They'll give you lots and lots of detailed and insightful data about your tour's traffic and success at hand, while also being probably the easiest way to enable tracking and statistics or analytics for your virtual tours, as it's natively integrated into the program with which you create your tours in the first place. And of course, your cloud control panel, along with all your tours uploaded to 3DVista Hosting and the 3DVista Analytics are also accessible on mobile, so you can access and share your tours wherever you are or check your analytics when you're on the go. Thanks for watching.